let's look at some questions about circular motion. Question 1. A CD rotates in a CD player at a rate of 2000 revolutions per minute. Find the angular speed omega and the linear speed v of both points x and y. Angular speed is given by omega equal to angular displacement over time, which equal to 2000 times 2 pi over 60, which is equal to 209 radian per second. The angular speed at x, at point x and at point y are the same, which means that they have the same value, equal to 209 radian per second. The formula for linear speed v is equal to angular speed omega times the radius. Therefore, velocity at x equal to 209 times radius at x equal to 10 cm, which is 0.1 meter. Vx equal to 20.9 meter per second. Similarly, Vy equal to 209 times the radius at y is equal to 0.06 meter. Therefore, the result is equal to 12.5 meter per second. Question number 2. A 0.2 kg block is attached on a string and is wheeled in a horizontal circle of radius 50 cm on the ground. The block makes 3 revolutions per second. Find the centrifugal force of the ball and the tension in the string. We know that centrifugal force equal to mass times centrifugal acceleration, which is equal to mass times AC, can be written in the form of V squared over R, or in another form equal to M omega squared R. Therefore, FC would be equal to 0.2 times omega. Omega is equal to 3 times 2 pi, 3 times 2 pi, omega square is 3 times 2 pi, the square of 3 times 2 pi, times the radius is 0.5 in meter, equal to 35.5 newton. Since the tension is the only force that provides the centripetal acceleration, that is, tension in this case equal to the centripetal acceleration. Therefore, the tension in the string equal to 35.5 newtons. Question number 3. A student swings a ball of mass 300 grams in a horizontal circle of radius 8 cm. The string connecting the ball makes an angle 30 degrees with the vertical. Find the speed of the ball, the tension in the string, and the centripetal force of the ball. The diagram shows how the ball performs circular motion. In fact, this kind of motion we call conical pendulum. First, let's draw the free body diagram on the ball. The force acting on the ball during its motion is tension of the string, its own weight, mg, Resolving tension into vertical component and horizontal component. We have the vertical component is T cosine theta, and the horizontal component is T sine theta. First, T cosine theta balance the weight, therefore they are equal. Next, T sine theta is pointing towards the center of the circle, therefore it is the centripetal force needed. Since T cosine theta equal to weight, we have T cosine theta is 30 degree equal to the mass is 0.3 kilogram, G is 9.81. Therefore, we can find tension first. 19 Newton. By using T sine theta equal to Fc, the centripetal force will be equal to 19 times sine 30 degree, which is equal to 9.5 Newton. Fc equal to 9.5 Newton. The centripetal force is equal to 9.5 Newton. By using Fc equal to mAc equal to mv squared over r, we can find v. We have 9.5 equal to 0.3 v squared over r is equal to 0.08. Therefore, we have the speed of the ball equal to 1.59 meters per second.